Nike was under a free throw and on the ice. Now, it just shows so much experience on such different kinds of terrain.
In all my years of climbing, I don't think I've seen another climber quite as hungry for it as Marc André. He's got this headspace that nobody else seems to have. Nothing phases him. I mean, it's the whole mentality of the ice doesn't have to be fully formed to be climbed. And so, kind of betting your tips from the ice, you're just kind of placing them on these little rock edges that adds another dimension of insecurity. Mark on this insecure terrain is terrifying. But he couldn't have been more relaxed. Then he took it up a notch by climbing solo on the notorious Stanley's Headwall. The Stanley Headwall is the centerpiece of Rocky's next climbing. None of the ice is 100% continuous. It forms in blobs and pillars and hanging daggers. You have to climb deep, overhanging rock just to get to the ice. And so it makes for really good engaging climbing.
There's a high degree of craftsmanship that has to go into the mixed climbing equation. Pick an ice axe to hang on to the smallest of edges. But you don't have the energy going to the end of the ice axe. You have to evaluate and test.
The difference between having your pick already seated in the hole and having the pick pulled off of it. Very, very small.
Honestly, I don't know if I've ever seen someone climb barehanded with ice rolls in freezing temps. You know, the improvise between pulling on the rock and pulling on ice rolls. It's just combining all the seven dimensional factors.